I started out teaching Econ 201 in the fall of 1967 to 500 undergraduates. Over the years, that's more than doubled. Now I'm teaching over 1,000 every fall semester. But I'm teaching it as though this will be the last course a student takes in the principles of microeconomics. What I want them to see is that econ is a way of thinking about the world, partly through a focus on the hard core of economic principles, partly by trying to illustrate them with examples. I'm teaching the law of diminishing marginal utility. I use an example of my niece having a dish of ice cream.
He kept on offering her ice cream, and each time he offered it, she was less and less happy with each consecutive scoop. I thought that was completely relatable and made the concept a lot easier to understand.
Sitting down the first day of class, I was immediately enthralled. He's very knowledgeable and passionate about what he teaches.
Before I took the class, everyone was saying, "You must take a class with Professor Elzinga because he's written this great mystery novel, he's famous."
Under the pen name of Marshall Jevons, my former colleague and dear friend William Bright and I have co-authored three mystery novels in which an economist is the central figure and solves the crime using economic analysis. Now, we had done academic articles and books before, so we were used to being co-authors, and now our four Marshall Jevons novels are assigned reading material in economics classes all over the country. I want the students in the large lecture to understand that if they want to see me, they can. They may have to wait a while, but I want the student who's sitting there and has been waiting for 30 minutes to know that I will stay around until I've seen all the students.
Immediately, you form a connection. He's a very personable man. He's very kind. He's a mentor.
A lot of my time is spent with students talking about career opportunities. The level of technical knowledge of the discipline that they take from here is really quite amazing. And so our graduates are highly sought after for graduate schools, not just in economics, but in law, medicine.
Thank you very much, Kevin.
Yeah,
hope the exam goes well.
Thank you very much.
Because of the number of students, there's no one room where they can all take the test. So they are spread all around the grounds. If anybody gets a perfect score on the final tonight, that'd be great, and I would love to meet you and take you out to lunch or dinner. And if anybody misses every question, I would like to meet you too. Same offer would hold, okay? The law of diminishing marginal utility doesn't really fit the way I view the classroom. When I start out in the fall, I'm still nervous again. I want to improve the course. Even after all these years, I haven't lost my passion for teaching. Thank you very much for your time this semester.